Good evening, everyone. Welcome to St. John's Memorial Stadium for Cable 9's presentation of tonight's American Hockey League game between the St. John's Maple Leafs and the Cape Breton Oilers. The Leafs remain on top of the American Hockey League standings in first place overall. They have 29 points, a record of 13-3-3. Now, just to get things settled down for tonight, you might recall that National Hockey League referees and the linesmen are on strike. So what that has created is that some of the linesmen, referees in the American Hockey League are under contract to the National Hockey League. So what happens here, these guys aren't refereeing. So in this particular case, last night marked the first time that a Newfoundlander had refereed a game in the American Hockey League. And of course, that was Gerard Hayes from St. John's. And needless to say, last night things, they can't get worse. They can get a lot better for Gerard and his boys from here on in. A real barn burner last night. St. John's won the game 4-3 over Cape Breton. But controversy around everywhere. Cape Breton said no. Chris Snell scored a goal with 14 seconds left in the third period, which turned out to be the eventual winner. Now, the puck was taken by Snell and seemed to be just a hapless shot being shot in, then hits off the post, and ding comes back out. So if you look at the replay, it looks like the puck hit the inside part of the post. But people said, no, it didn't do that. But if you look at it and you see it over and over, as I had a chance to do just before we came on here on Cable 9, the puck seems to hit the inside and the ding back out. And of course, it goes out to Curtis Hunt, who runs the clock out. And the St. John's Maple Leafs come up with that big win last night over Cape Breton, 4-3. So we'll have to wait and see exactly what transpires tonight. But Chris Snell was the hero. We noticed tonight as well with St. John's, who were out practicing just before the game, getting their warm-ups in. Kenny McRae is not with them now on their latest road trip. He suffered, got hit in the head in his helmet with the puck and suffered a minor concussion. Glenn Stanford told me before the game he's still suffering the effects of that. He apparently got 10 stitches, so it may be a while before Kenny McRae comes back. But Todd Gillingham is back in the lineup for the St. John's Maple Leafs, and Gilly looks pretty good out there. Last night had a goal in his comeback with the St. John's Maple Leafs, so things looking up for Gilly. And the win last night at the stadium, they're 8-1-2 at home, the St. John's Maple Leafs. So what more can you say about the team? Some interesting things for you tonight to look at. Buddy the Puffin celebrates his birthday tonight, and it should be interesting to see what the fans have in store for Buddy the Puffin, the mascot for the St. John's Maple Leafs. Well, they're getting ready outside to clean the ice and get ready for this game between St. John's and Cape Breton. And earlier today, it was Brendan McCarthy having a discussion with Rich Chernomaz of the St. John's Maple Leafs and George Burnett, the coach of the Cape Breton Oilers. And we'll go to that interview. Here's Brendan.
Game, winning it in the last minute was very crucial from our standpoint, because now we're 10 points back up in Cape Breton rather than 6. I think another crucial point is the fact that with the call-ups and stuff, it gives the opportunity for some of the younger guys to go out there and raise their potential of play with the more amount of ice time that they have. Another point is the fact of Alexei Kudryashov coming down and having developed and getting some ice time to get that chance to go back up to Toronto, you know, and he's really come on of the last couple of games. I think that's been pretty important. But I think the most important thing is that we just have to maintain the level of play that we have in the past. And I think for the most part, we've done a pretty good job. You know, we've been low on numbers, and yet the guys have really bared down, and we've found ways to win or keep ourselves in all the games so far.
Do you tell youngsters who are seeing more ice time and are put into more of an important role with the hockey team, do you tell them that they're expected to come through, or is it something that you figure is just understood?
Well, you just, you know, through a few of our meetings and stuff in game preparation, you know, there might be the odd statement made, but I think the guys are smart enough to realize that, hey, you know, this is the time that they have to shine because of the you know, extra amount of ice time that they're getting in certain situations. And, you know, guys like Ryan Vandenbusch have really, you know, jumped to that occasion. You know, I think he really, you know, the last couple of games, he's really complimented a guy like Alexei and Patrick Augusta, just because with his presence out there, he compliments them in the extra ice or room that they can get out there.
Can you tell us about Rich Chernomaz? Just a fantastic start to the season. The power play, I think your performance there is a story in itself, but as much as this is a grind for everybody, it's got to be a grind for Rich Chernomaz, who's got to deal not only with what players have to deal with, but your extra load as an assistant coach. is there any way that you kind of combat maybe the mental fatigue more than anything?
Well, I think the bottom line is that you mentally have to stay tough, and you know, regardless of some days when you're hurting a little more than others, you just got to maintain that same focus and not, you know, make up any excuses, you know, or saying you're tired or you're sore or whatever. You know, you just got to go out there and play the same way, you know. And some games are going to be a lot tougher than the others. You know, the last couple of games have been pretty intense. You know, there's been a lot of chippiness, a lot of physical play out there and stuff. So when things aren't coming as well offensively for you, then that's when you got to simplify your game and just play tough along the boards and in the corners, and hopefully that'll rub off on the rest of the players. And you know, I think for the most part, guys have really come to play and play hard and just do those little things that have kept us in all these games since our call-ups.
Well, I think, you know, one, we're real happy to be coming off the season we had. Again, it's in the past, and I don't think we talk about it a lot now, and I'm kind of glad that it's all the festivities and the rings and all the other stuff are kind of over with. We can, there's not a lot of guys left from last year's club, and yet there's a few key people that I think are quality key people in our team this year, like a Gordon Mark and Mark LaForge and Wayne Cowley, and the list is a longer one. Brad Warenk is here at this particular time, and Roman Akshut is in Sydney this weekend. We expect to see him in our lineup next week, and you know, so there is some connections there. I think with what's going on within the organization right now, it's a great time to be a young player in our organization. Whether they're starting here, and I think there's been 8 or 9 guys get a chance to go to Edmonton already this year, or call ups and send downs, and that's got to be motivation in itself for the young guys that are here, saying, look, if the big team is made a commitment to the young guys, and it's a great opportunity for everybody to get a chance. And if I play well here, I'm going to get that chance. And a lot of those kids have, and there's a few that have played well, the Tyler Wrights and Joseph Cherney. And a few others. Martini's been really good, and Bakula, and a lot of those guys that it's just going to be probably a matter of time before maybe they get a call and get a chance to play some games in the National League. Peter White, Jimmy Nessage have been outstanding for us, and I don't know that there's continuity anywhere near where we'd like to have it, as you talked about. And right now we've got 25 people in our team right now, and I don't know that that's real healthy. I think sometimes that creates competition, but it also says that some of the young guys that are in the organization like now, Zavisha and Internova, for example, aren't getting a lot of ice time. And until we can make some of those decisions, and hopefully we'll do that this week when we get back off this road trip and find out where certain people fit in and what the plans are. Until the smoke clears in Edmonton, I don't know that we can make a lot of those decisions. And we're certainly in need of some people in certain areas on our hockey club to make everybody more effective. And I think when you look down our lineup, you see a lot of individual toughness and a lot of those things, and we're trying to generate that into team presence and team physical presence to create chances to score goals and things like that, and hopefully we can get that done over the next few weeks. I think our division is, again, continues to be tremendously competitive, and if you have a great week, you can be at the top, and if you have a bad week, you can kind of be at the bottom holding everybody up, and I don't imagine it's going to change all year long. We'd certainly like to keep within distance of the St. John's team, and as we improve over the course of the year, I think we can challenge them, but they're doing a great job, and Mark's got them playing very well, and they deserve a tremendous amount of credit so far.